Thank you for joining us on this broadcast. My name is Msa Yakubu. Today, what is glaucoma? Who is at risk of having glaucoma? What can be done? Is the disease reversible or not? All this in a short while as we get to meet the doctor. Do stay with us.
The World Glaucoma Week is a period of recognition that has been given to glaucoma as a disease, as a public health disease. And it was done essentially to raise awareness about glaucoma because of the importance of glaucoma. Glaucoma is an important disease because it affects a lot of people. The way it causes the disease is gradual, and it continues until there's blindness. And the blindness that it causes cannot be reversed, cannot be treated. So you cannot treat the blindness and the patient regains vision. So you can only manage the patient the way it is. So it means that it's a serious disease because there's really nothing you can do about it when it has already happened. And the awareness creation became necessary because we find that so many people present late when the disease has already caused blindness. And not due to any fault of theirs, it's because of the way the disease affects the eye. It's gradual. It doesn't have any symptoms and only presents with symptoms when the vision is gone. So when that happens, there's nothing else to do. So they looked at it and thought, look, the major issue here is awareness so that more and more people can know about the disease and come forward voluntarily to screen, because it is only by screening that you can detect the disease. And the only way to prevent blindness is to detect disease early. If the disease is detected early, then blindness can be prevented. So that is the whole essence of the World Glaucoma Week, to ensure that we make so much noise about glaucoma, get more and more people to know about it, get more and more people to come up for screening. So, and in this wise, we work with a lot of stakeholders, governments, hospitals, professional bodies, so there are a number of groups. So the WHO, International Agency for Prevention of Blindness, World Blindness Union, global bodies have deemed it fit that one should dedicate a week-long period of recognition to glaucoma to ensure that more and more people know about it, more and more people come up to be screened so that we can prevent blindness from glaucoma. It's a disease that affects the optic nerve of the eye. The optic nerve of the eye is, I will liken it to a wire. It's a wire that connects the eyeball to the brain. So it tells the brain that this is what you're seeing. So that's what the optic nerve is. So the glaucoma actually affects the optic nerve. And it does so due to several factors. The commonest factor, risk factor that will help, that will make one develop a damage of the optic nerve is when there's an increase in the pressure of the eye. You know, the pressure, there's a normal pressure of the eye that maintains the integrity of the eye, maintains the shape of the eye, and allows the eye to function properly and for vision to take place accurately. When that pressure builds up and is too high, it normally would want to, the pressure would escape to damage the weakest point of the eyeball. And that weakest point of the eyeball is where the optic nerve leaves the eyeball. So with a build-up in pressure, there's damage of the optic nerve. The optic nerve actually is actually a collection of nerve fibers from the retina. They are nerve axons of the retinal ganglion cells that come together to form a bundle of nerves. They leave the eye and send in information from the eye to the brain. And being nerves, they don't regenerate. That is why glaucoma is difficult, because once nerves are damaged, they don't regenerate, hardly regenerate. So that is what the problem. That's why vision loss in glaucoma is irreversible. So that's essentially what glaucoma is.